What's up, gentlemen? So there are certain things that we wear as men that make us look more feminine, like earrings and toms and purple t-shirts with kittens. And as men, there are certain things that we do that make us look feminine, like shaving our legs and overly arching our eyebrows. And oh my God, Brian, did you hear about Janice and Sheila, what they did to Brad?
Gossiping.
Not that there is anything wrong with being perceived or viewed as feminine, but if you are somebody that is wanting to be perceived as more manly or macho, then you can modify these things, not wear them, not do them in order to be more manly. But unfortunately, there are some other characteristics that you may possess that are giving other people the impression that you are more feminine. Physical characteristics that make you look more feminine. Now, unfortunately, we can't change our genetics, but there are some things that we can do in order to modify them and make us look and appear more manly. Starting with number one, man boobs. Man boobs make men look more feminine. Now, unfortunately, man boobs are incredibly embarrassing. They are also more common than you realize. There are two different types of man boobs, and treating them really depends on the type that you have. The first type is gynecomastia, all right? This is actually a medical condition caused by typically an increase in estrogen level. A lot of young men, when they're growing up, will actually get this. So gynecomastia is a medical condition. The other type of man boob is what I call fat titties. Dudes that carry a little excess body fat in their chest area, giving the illusion of a titty. Now, in terms of treating or managing your man boobs, there are a few things you can do aesthetically, all right? You can wear a compression garment, like an undershirt that's a little bit too tight. You could also rock dark colors. Dark colors do minimize man boobs. But if you want to turn those man boobs into pecs of steel, gentlemen, a few things you can do. Reduce your body fat, also increase the muscle mass. Now, if you have gyno, even if you reduce your body fat, oftentimes you're still going to be able to see it. If that is the case, you can always go in and have surgery to remove it. The second thing that make men look more feminine is a luscious booty and wide hips. Like, some dudes are like top heavy, right? The big jack dudes with like little skinny legs, right? Well, some dudes are bottom heavy. They might be a little bit larger down below. They got bigger legs. They might have a little bigger booty. Their hips are a little wider. In order to minimize the appearance of a larger lower body, guys, it's all about balance, all right? You use color in order to help balance your body, all right? There's light and there's dark. Dark colors make things smaller, light colors bigger. And so what I recommend, if you are somebody who is a little bit larger lower body, wear dark colors, dark jeans. Also, up top, go light. In terms of the fit of your pants, guys, you want to stay away from like super skinny tight jeans. And the reason, of course, it's going to hug your body and actually accentuate your shape. Instead, what I'd recommend is go with a straight leg jean or something with a moderate to mild taper. In terms of weightlifting, I want you to build your upper body, right? Work on the chest, the shoulders, the back to make you a little bit wider and thicker up top to balance out the body. In terms of working your legs, you can still work them. Go lower weight, higher reps. The third thing that make men look feminine is super soft, buttery smooth hands. I'm just saying to work out. Work out, gentlemen. Look at my hands. They might be small, but they are manly. Bringing us to the fourth thing that make dudes look feminine, which is teeny little feet. Now, a few things that you can actually do. You can size up, all right? So if you're normally like a 6, go 6.5. If you're a 7, go 7.5, possibly an 8. And add an insert into it to actually help your foot fill out the shoe. Some other things that you can do is wear boots. Boots with a little thicker lug sole are going to give the illusion of your feet being a little bit larger. Something else you can do is wear sneakers with laces as opposed to slip-ons. And the reason is because the laces are going to add more bulk to your feet. Something else you can do, guys, is wear light-colored or white sneaks. Wearing white sneakers also make your feet look bigger because they bounce and reflect the light. The fifth thing that make guys look more feminine is low muscle mass and tone. Unfortunately, as men age, a lot of weird things start to happen with their body. One of those things is actually loss of muscle mass. Another downside is that after the age of 30, your testosterone level starts to drop by about 1% per year. And that's why our friend and today's video sponsor, Roman, has a new supplement designed to support testosterone production. They formulated their own supplements with transparent and scientifically backed ingredients. Roman's testosterone supplement is for anybody who wants to support their body's natural function. And getting started, guys, is super simple. All you gotta do is hit that link down below, getroman.com/alphadailies. Their supplement contains vitamin D3, zinc, magnesium, maca, and ashwagandha in a unique blend designed by doctors that you can't get anywhere else. Guys, to learn more about this incredible supplement or the ingredients, all you gotta do is hit that link down below. flow. GetRoman.com/AlphaDailies. And if you go through our special link, guys, they're giving you $15 off your first order plus free two-day shipping. That's GetRoman.com/AlphaDailies for $15 off plus free two-day shipping. The sixth thing that make guys look, or I should say sound, more feminine is a high voice. Yeah, got this one covered. So here's the deal. Guys, if you missed the video that I did talking about how to develop a more manly voice, gentlemen, I'm going to link to it down below. In that video, I go over some general speaking tips to make whatever voice you have better. The seventh thing that make men look more feminine is weak and submissive body language. Guys, the way that you carry yourself, the way that you walk, the fact that you are standing with your chest up, shoulders back, and walking, looking people in the eye. When you sit, right? When you sit, I'm okay with you man-spreading a little bit, taking up space. If you're super small, if you cross your legs in a more feminine fashion, this is going to give other people the perception that you are more feminine. When you shake somebody's hand, gentlemen, do not get owned by the other dude or woman that you are shaking. Gentlemen, it is all about planning. It is all about preparation. You've got to anticipate the squeeze. There's nothing worse than when you go to shake somebody's hand and like you're not ready for it, right? Or you don't hit them perfectly like in the web and you don't squeeze first, exactly. And your hand crumbles like a little girl. I cannot tell you how critical it is that you develop an incredible handshake. And this isn't just for dudes, this is for women. All three of you that watch this channel. Apparently there are three women that watch the AlphaM YouTube channel, and for you, you better have a strong ass handshake too. I'm telling you, whenever I meet a woman and she shakes my hand like a dude or like a woman who's strong and not like, exactly, I respect her more. Practice shaking hands with a friend, a family member, your mom, your dad, your weird uncle Barry. Second thought, not Barry. We don't know where those hands have been. Last but certainly not least, the eighth thing that make men look feminine is a super weak jaw. Now, here's the thing. Unfortunately, the majority of us were not born with chiseled Greek strong jaws, but there's some things that you can do in order to give the jaw you have more structure and depth, and that includes growing a little facial hair action. Facial hair is an amazing way to add structure, strength, and manliness to your face, but it's all about where you actually trim it. So here's the deal. If you are somebody who is shaving too far up here, you're exposing all the neck meat fat. The way that you find the boundary, guys, head straight, finger here, boom, right? Shave everything below, leave everything above. So growing facial hair or a beard is a way to visually add bulk and structure and strength and masculinity to your face. Now, if you want to really change it, you could lose weight, all right? That's a great way to actually make your face more defined. Or if you want to take it to the next level, guys, you could go in and have a mentoplasty. That is a plastic surgery procedure. Give you a little cut under the chin, and then they insert a little chin implant, and then simultaneously they're gonna liposuction a little bit of your neck and actually tighten up all those muscles there to give your chin a stronger, more masculine look. In conclusion, I would like to let you know something. I am not exactly what you would call a super manly, masculine dude, right? It's something that I've been aware of from a very young age. I'm a small guy, I've got a high voice, and I wear earrings, I do my eyebrows, and I've always manscaped. And so I have been called everything from gay to fag to whatever you wanna call it for years. And the truth is that I don't care. I'm me, I love me, and I hope you love you. But hopefully a few of these things, if you modify and change, will give you a more masculine, confident look.